Tja, wir kommen zum Ende dieser spannenden zwei Tage. Und ihr werdet es nicht glauben, ich muss mal auf die Uhr schauen.
You won't believe it, I have to look at my watch.
Die Infrastruktur-Review hat angekündigt, sie will tatsächlich...
So, the crew has announced that they want to start on time.
Peter und Danimo muss ich ja nicht...
I don't really have to introduce their Peter and Danimo to you.
So
there's a little bit of time.
Das waren zwei spannende
that
Tage.
Were two very interesting days.
Das, wir so online machen und was geht und was
and
nicht geht.
We tried to figure out what works and what doesn't work. And us Viennese, we have the Privacy Week.
So,
and
Eindruck,
the way it looks right now, we won't be able to can do that in person. The Viennese want to do the Danube Festival to want that to happen, and they moved it to the fall time. I personally think that is very optimistic. But I'm listening from hearing from the director. We can get going. Ladies and gentlemen, I like to introduce der Peter and Danimo with the infrastructure and closing for DVOC, the first online conference at Easter 2020.
Go ahead.
Ja, dann einen wunderschönen guten Abend.
Yeah, welcome to our infrastructure and closing. We figured we need a little bit more Congress atmosphere here. So we picked Saal 1 from the CCH. Danimo and I will give you an overview of what has happened and what all the teams have done and how that all worked technically. So it started all with communication. Here is some statistics. There is an IRC channel on Hackend with up to 350 people and a Matrix channel with 245 users. Then we have the C3 Lingo team. We are translating remote via Mumble because we don't have translation cabins. And we could be listened to via Mumble and also go into the second channel. And we were able to translate from German into English and vice versa. And there even some of the talks were into French, and most of it has been recorded. That I already told you. And the translators were able to watch a stream that is presenting a signal much earlier than what other people got to see. This allowed us to have the translation audio be actually ahead of the video stream. Then let's go to merch. You have ordered incredibly lot. Until 9 this evening, you ordered 450 shirts, 100 hoodies, 130 zippers, and almost 170 jogging pants. So we had no idea how many people would actually order something, and we found a small shop in Hamburg we found her with a little small shop in Hamburg, the online shop, and now she got so many orders in that she actually had to hire 3 more people, more self-employed people who now are actually getting paid and despite the whole COVID problem. And the merch orders will be delivered after Easter. And there was an info desk available under phone number 1111. You could also dial in externally, and they looked at Twitter and Mastodon and IRC and Matrix. There were about 30 requests. Nine calls were received, one from the EVPN and four via the internal zip, and one from the external phone network, and no special calls to our special number.
So,
the Chaos Post. For this event,
Statistiken sind irgendwie nicht so richtig
beeindruckend,
aber eben dem Umstand geschuldet.
Given the situation, physically delivering postcards wasn't really possible here, so there were zero postcards delivered. So no people were employed delivering posts, and there were exactly zero trees used in creating postcards. But they did design one specific a postcard design just for this event, and the post office will be open until 11:42. And just 10 minutes ago, 523 postcards were delivered digitally at over 30 top-level domains, and 13 different postcard designs and all different kinds of stamps were available, and surprisingly, none of them actually ran out, surprising with digital materials. So the CERT was available under the usual number 1818. It was called twice. So it was staffed 24 hours, with doctors and other personnel, and 0 kilometers had to be run by the people in the CERT. The fire safety behavior was exemplary. The CERT did not, nobody did anything about the smoking ban, and so it was an exemplary event.
Genau, kommen wir zum VOG. Und da können wir tatsächlich irgendwas sagen, was wir nicht nur...
Okay, let's talk about VOG. So here we can actually say something that is not just PowerPoint Karaoke. We had 18 sessions, all of them remote. One was pre-recorded, all the others were live.
Das Ganze haben moderiert fünf.
It was moderated by 5 remote heralds. And we had approximately 800 viewers in peak on our streams on MediaCCC.de. We also played it out to YouTube, which gave us another 150 viewers at the peak in both original language, native language, and translation. Nobody's left behind. We didn't do YouTube playout in a while, but because we wanted to reach everybody also on the platforms that don't have a MediaCCC app available, we did it this time again. And there was a live translation via Mumble, as you already mentioned. Peter, can you say something about the infrastructure? So, we needed to get a somewhat usable video feed from the speakers at home. So Jitsi and everything was out of the question. We asked all the speakers to install OBS, the Open Broadcast Studio, then use that to send the stream to us using RTMP. We accepted it with an Nginx relay and put it into another OBS that is running in a data center, and we use a remote desktop session for managing the streams and the views. That worked pretty well. We spent one day trying to do it in the VM, then delivering it on bare metal. And we ended up using Gnome Machine because we needed lowest latency possible and synchronous audio. It's yeah, remote is something and it's surprisingly good.
So, dann das
right, then the playout.
Das haben wir im Prinzip gemacht, wie schon zum letzten Kongress.
Basically, you did the same thing as at the previous Congress.
Eine Änderung.
Except for one, at least one change.
HLS ausgeliefert über
we played out HLS via Nginx and
mit, Opus
Dash und using Opus und MP3 for audio.
Das Ganze kam über OBS. Hat auch WAPI,
everything came from OBS benutzt, using WAPI
auf ein, Nginx RTMP,
and went into an Nginx RTMP and then
FFmpeg,
to an FFmpeg. And FFmpeg
gleich in einem sowohl das H264 durchgereicht,
copied H264 and generated a SD version using VIP. We added AVD9 Full HD, but in software, because we did some benchmarks
and
the hardware VP9 did not look great in HD. So we did that in software, but the SD version we did in hardware, which is better. And Opus MP3 using libopus and MP3 lame. All of that in one FFmpeg call. And we also just released the stream player. It's now on github.com/vog/vogplayer. You can just embed streaming media CCC content on your website easily. Yeah, that's it already. Or should there be anything else?
Ich weiß es nicht. Also irgendwas fehlte.
I don't know. I think something is missing.
Hallo.
Oh yeah, this. Hey.
Das Pock.
This is Pock.
Hallo.
Hallo.
Mr. Spock.
Hallo.
Entschuldigung.
Hallo, hallo.
Ja, wir haben einige Dinge zu erzählen.
We have a few things to tell.
Wir beginnen ja einfach mal mit den Statistiken.
Just going to start with some stats. We have some stats again, as usual.
Und wir haben diesmal leider kein DECT angeboten.
Unfortunately, this time we did not offer a DECT network. Despite all rumors to the opposite, there is no country-wide DECT network, but there is SIP. We also add documentation how you configure Fritzbox for the SIP. Some people actually did that. We had 300 active registration and approximately 8,000 calls. That's quite nice.
Soweit zu den Statistiken. Ja, traditionell kann man jetzt schon
traditionally sagen, you'd say
haben wir immer wieder Dinge getestet,
we keep auf dem testing things
Test in Folge.
On Easter Hack. First one you probably all remember. We deregistered all devices because we wanted to try a new self-registration process. Then in Vienna, we collected data to better understand the protocol. And it's also the first time we used CloudDeck, so our DECT base station was remote. We went to Easterhack in Vienna with an enterprise firewall, and then later we realized we don't even need the enterprise firewall. So for the third test, we said there's two different motivations why we want to change things. One is that we have more and more events that ask us to do the POC for them. So we asked ourselves, how can we handle that? How can we scale this to any kinds of events? And maybe it's better that we allow people, enable people. So we create a POC environment. We can just give people and have kind of a distributed POC, which also enables us to get pull requests to improve our POC here. And the second motivation is our routing. That we completely re-implemented with the new base station and the self-registration. So we reached a point where we couldn't scale any further because it was implemented in the MySQL store procedure, so we ran into some problems.
benutzt hatten, der so auf dem Camp so einen kleinen Bug getriggert, der dazu geführt hat, dass bestimmte...
So, that triggered a small bug during camp,
ja, nicht, also
which caused some group members to be unreachable. So, yeah, for these reasons, we decided to do some more changes, and we created a new environment, we call it NanoPOC.
Und das ist so, dass wir das komplett reproduzierbar...
And this NanoPOC is completely reproducible. So now we have both an environment we can publish on GitHub at some point and also implemented a new routing that takes all the known requirements and restructures them. So I would like to just give a quick overview over NanoPOC and its features.
Im Grundsatz jetzt auf Ansible-Technologie aufgesetzt.
Everything is based on Ansible to create virtual machines using Vagrant.
Und das Kern unseres
The core of POC ist a YAML-File.
Im Moment eingetragen und bestartet. Kann man darin definieren, welche
so you can define the interfaces you want, which VPNs you want,
also aus welchen Ecken, dass ich da jemand einwählen kann, welche Maschinen, welche IP-Adressen, welche
ZIP-Trunks, which machines, which IP addresses,
die Idee ist,
which ZIP trunks.
Konfiguriert, also jemand checkt dieses
Repository. So the idea is that somebody checks out this repository, configures the YAML,
mit all den
verschiedenen, they need it.
Ja, sag ich mal, Informationen. Packt die Closed Source Binaries mit dazu,
also
die RPM-Pakete für unser Deck-Setup und dann
Closed Source Binaries, such as the firmware for the Deck-Setup, and then you have a complete POC instance, including all the VMs you need. So, yeah, this first time we tried it and it worked. So, everybody could call each other.
Hat sich jetzt praktisch ein neues
and that result in new functionality. So I would hand it over to Gavin. Yeah, hello also from me.
Genau, also was sich viele von euch irgendwie in der Vergangenheit ist, dass wir an der Gruppenfunktionalität
lots of you have asked for improvements in the group functionality. So both functionality in the user interface in Guru,
als auch irgendwie neue Funktionen,
but also adding new features. Und,
was ihr jetzt irgendwie schon sehen könnt,
which you can already see,
dass wir tatsächlich
es is that we managed during
Devok, was ja so als Devok, Hackersatz dient, und zwar irgendwie das Frontend hier wirklich neu zu
to improve the frontend. So if you go to call groups
in unserem Benutzer
UI,
dann seht ihr, dass das fast genauso,
you can see it looks früher, similar to what it used to look like, but not quite, because now we have this new interface for groups.
Dann können wir mal kurz
durchgehen. Just step through that, take a look at that, and see which new functionalities this offers. So the membership UI looks like this. This is an empty group that I just created for test purposes. I'm just going to add my extension here. And what's new is that if you go to call groups here, you can see the invite and you can just say, hey, I want to accept this invite, I want to join this 2099 group.
Dann seht ihr auch, dass ich jetzt hier irgendwie auftauche. Und es gibt
and you can see that I show up in the list here.
Irgendwie von Leuten, dass sie sagen, ja, ich bin ja ganz grundsätzlich in dieser Gruppe drin.
Aber and lots of people asked us to add a pause feature, because yes, I'm part of the group, but sometimes I just want to take a break. So there's a pause button here now. If you click that, your membership is suspended. And you see the icon here, which shows that you're currently on break. And as long as you're paused, your membership is paused, you don't get any of the calls until you click the play button again.
Und wir haben auch mal irgendwie das Interface überarbeitet, habt ihr gesehen.
We also gave the interface a bit of a rework.
Zum Beispiel will man den Sascha hinzufügen.
For example, here I'm adding Sascha, so now you can administrate this group as well.
Wir hoffen, dass jetzt alles ein bisschen übersichtlich
ist. We hope that everything got a little bit more,
dass auch viele neue Dinge irgendwie auch gehen.
More easier to use. Also, lots of people ask for groups to be able to add them to groups, so. Basically subgroups, so we just added the POC group.
Jetzt ist in meiner Test
now my test group 2099 actually contains the entire POC group, 2000 extension, that did not work before.
dieser Administrationsview von uns, den kennt ihr wahrscheinlich nicht. Dann seht ihr hier
oben. And you can also see this administration view.
Das Pending Changes, das funktioniert so, dass die Webseite generiert quasi so ein
Event Stream. See Pending Changes here, so the website creates an Event Stream.
Wenn ich Leute zum Beispiel hinzufüge oder hier nochmal irgendwie auf
den And that event stream tells the base station what to do. So if I click that, that creates an event internally that is sent forward to the base station, to the PBX. And we can always see how many changes are still pending, which is a good indicator whether there is a synchronization issue.
Ja, ach so, und für diejenigen von euch, die irgendwie glauben, man kann jetzt irgendwie Unfug machen, wenn ich jetzt hier in der POC-Gruppe zum Beispiel
so for those of you that try to add to build loops or be mischievous anyway, if I try to do that this way, that's not work. That would create a loop. So nobody wants that.
Sich viele von euch irgendwie noch gewünscht, dass man so verzögert kann in der Gruppe. Da haben wir gedacht, naja, da das haben wir noch nicht geschafft, aber das verwirrt vielleicht viele Leute.
Others also ask for delay or staggered call, so but it could be confusing, so we added a parameter called expert mode. And if you use that, you can configure.
Ja, nee, so war das eigentlich nicht gedacht. Also eigentlich sollte.
Okay.
Ich glaube, das ist irgendwie noch nicht so fertig. Ja, ich glaube, da müssen wir wirklich nochmal ran. Aber dann, also, wenn man fertig ist, dann tauchen hier so Texte.
Okay, yeah, that's not intended. I guess we have to fix that.
Dass man da so Delays eingeben kann, sodass irgendwer
zum Beispiel später klingelt, sodass people fields that appear, and then you can add a delay, like a first and second level support, so it doesn't ring everyone at the same time. Anyway,
was wir jetzt irgendwie konfigurieren können, ist viel mehr.
You can see it's much more configurable than before. There's a start stop. I can add groups to groups.
Und wir
halt irgendwie auch so. And soon also configure delays, which requires significantly more complex routing. And as a consequence of that, we decided we needed to work on our tooling to debug everything.
Civilian mal Zeit genommen und versucht, das Debug-Tooling
irgendwie so aufzuhübschen.
Und
ich took some time
so den Eindruck
to improve the Debug-Tooling. And I think that is something that's really cool. So
ja, dann
I would like to touch on that.
Ich schau mal,
let's see if I can show it to you.
So, und ihr seht hier schon,
you can already see the problem with the significantly more complex routing.
Relativ übersichtliche Baumdarstellung, was
this is a pretty simple tree view of what happens when Gavin calls the project management. For example, the forward, if it's if busy, then it goes to POC.
Mitglieder und
and then the group has a lot of members, and one of these is Gavin who called. So we shouldn't ring for that. Then there is delayed ringing. For example, for me and Dani, it only rings after 5 seconds. We can forward to external. So for example, if PL Runner doesn't pick up after 2 seconds, then it starts ringing the Telekom hotline. Then if you look at, for example, Sasha here, there is a multi-ringer. So the moment that his headset rings, it also calls 2005 because it's a desk phone. And to visualize all of that and understand what's happening around that, we created this visualization tool. And the goal is for us to give you all of this functionality also in Guru. And let's see when we can manage that.
Auf diesem Event sehr hilfreich war, ist live in die Anlage reinzuschauen, was da so passiert. Und dafür haben wir uns hier nebenstelle einfach anzeigt, ja, was genau da gerade
passiert. And then it's also interesting to debug Gate. So here, for example, I see somebody is trying to call me, but I can't pick up.
Ich kann ja mal die 2000 anrufen.
So I'm in a phone conference, but I can call 2000. You can see it's starting to ring with all of these people. You can watch live what happens with SIP.
wir auch sehen, wenn
we can see how the calls are routed.
Routed werden.
Also so, wenn ich for example, if I'm just going to
durchstellen lasse von dem
SIP-Server. And so you can see how it goes back from GSM to premium.
Die Netzansage ran und ich kann live zu.
Und
das ist jetzt einmal über einen momentanen Einsatz haben.
So you can see in the dashboard.
Ihn ja auch in dem Dashboard sieht. Dort
you can see that there's many more than zero decked calls.
Daran, dass wir
ja, also ihr habt ja jetzt gesehen,
as you can see, we can do things like call forwarding und and group rings. So you can see on the backend side, we added the necessary parts and we can add that to the phone system, but the front end is missing. And we think we can fix that during this year. So when we are going to be allowed again to be all physically together, we can show that and use that. And you're absolutely invited to stop by our Tisch, but all this work you have to do yourself. So there's one last thing, the table installation. If you so the best thing is to switch out the Jitsi at the last minute for a big blue button. And that's it from us. So we're going to ask and answer a couple of questions. Since not all of the teams are here, we're doing that kind of randomly. So, should I moderate those, or do you want to read them out yourself? So, let me say the fact that you just sat in front of the computer and did nothing but fully electronically. So we just heard that the statistics didn't say how many times the Android app got downloaded, 153 times, and we can't say more for data protection reasons. So how much bandwidth was used, and by how many times was NOC bandwidth over-provisioned this time? So the problem with this bandwidth measurement, we have no feedback from the NSA, and the network operators didn't want to tell us directly, so we have to give you that information later. And then there's a question.
Nach, wie man jetzt
how would you count how would you count the call
auf die
to that number to this very long number
8199
so there was only a long dial tone and then silence. Is that supposed to be like that? Asking from the distributed translation cabin. So what you should hear is a ringback tone, and the ringback tone should read back the number you dialed. And there was a problem, apparently. And another question is the search for extensions only can look for names, not the numbers?
Ja, Namen von Gruppen statt Extensions
meine ich jetzt in der Liste. Aber das so wir in the phone book genau. You can find all groups that are marked as visible. So when you add people to a group, it should work with both their extension and their name. And if it doesn't work, it's a bug. And can you actually add chat rooms? Uh, We already have that. There is the 8800.
Gruppenraum, das ist die 8800.
And we'll try to have that made configurable in the Python line. There is a sample project on GitHub, and that allows you to convert your extension into a conference. So, you want to do some silly bits? We haven't prepared any silly bits. So, and that wraps that up, and we will have some DJ sets from midnight. And otherwise, lots of thanks to the organization that made this possible, every people who supplied machines, ideas, who somehow implemented their ideas of how to create this distributed online chaos. And I was really surprised what all happened and got generated. And I can only say the same. Please use the mumbles and big buttons and just pretend that we're all together. Have fun. At the machine.